Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh, and a very good day I wish to all, especially to our beloved lecturer Madam Wahidah Binti Tumijan. Today I'm going to present my research proposal. This video presentation was made to fulfill one of my individual assignment for the subject of research methodology in sport and behavior science, SRT603. Okay, before I start, let me introduce myself. My name is Abdullah Sharami bin Ismail, student number 2021-306753. And this is my research title, Organizational Commitment and its Correlation with Employee Well-being among Healthcare Workers at Tengku Azizah Hospital, Kuala Lumpur. Okay, before I start, this is basically my outline of today's presentation. Today's presentation basically cover three major chapter, which is chapter 1, introduction, that has research background, problem statement, research objective, and the significance of the study. While in chapter 2, literature review, I'm gonna give an overview of literature review, factor influencing organizational commitment, employee well-being and its determinants, methodologies used in previous study, result from previous study, and gaps in literature. Last but not least, in chapter 3, which is methodology, I'm gonna give an overview of methodology and then research design, sample size and sampling technique, instrumentation, data collection procedure, data analysis, and lastly, references. Okay, today I will be discussing the background of my study, which is focusing on the relationship between organizational commitment, OC, and employee well-being, EWB, among healthcare workers at Tengku Azizah Hospital in Kuala Lumpur. Okay, the first one is definition of organizational commitment. Organizational commitment refers to the psychological attachment and loyalty an employee feels toward their organization. This can be categorized into three components: effective commitment, continuous commitment, and normative commitments. While the definition of employee well-being, EWB, employee well-being encompasses the overall physical, psychological, and social health of employees, including job satisfaction, work-life balance, mental health, and interpersonal relationship. Why this study is important in healthcare? Okay, OC and EWB are critical in healthcare setting as they directly impact job performance and turnover rates. High level of organizational commitment can lead to increased job performance and reduce turnover intention. Okay, let's continue the research backgrounds. Okay, why this study relevant to Tengku Azizah Hospital? There are two main reasons of this. The first reason is high job demand and stress. Healthcare workers at Tengku Azizah Hospital face high job demand and stress, which can negatively affect their well-being and commitment to the organization. Studies have shown that high stress level among healthcare workers lead to burnout and reduced job satisfaction. The second reason, specific challenges faced by healthcare workers. The hospital experiences a high turnover rate, which disrupt patient care and increase the workload on remaining staff. Addressing OC and EWB can help mitigate this issue and improve overall organizational performance. In summary, by understanding the relationship between OC and EWB, we can develop strategies to enhance employee retention, job satisfaction, and patient care at Tengku Azizah Hospital. Okay, still in the research background, previous research findings found three major factors. The first one is impact of OC on EWB. Research has demonstrated a positive correlation between organizational commitment and employee well-being. Employees with higher organizational commitment tend to report better overall well-being, including mental health and job satisfaction. And then the role of management support. Management support plays a crucial role in enhancing both organizational commitment and employee well-being. study have shown that supportive management practice lead to higher level of employee commitment and better well-being outcome. And last, in the context of healthcare, high organizational commitment is associated with improved job performance and reduced turnover intention. For instance, healthcare workers with strong organizational commitment are more likely to stay with their organization and provide high quality patient care. This finding highlight the importance of fostering organizational commitment to enhance employee well-being and overall organizational effectiveness in healthcare setting. Okay, in this slide, I will discuss the critical issues of high turnover rates and job satisfaction among healthcare workers and their impact on patient care and organizational performance. Okay, the first problem statement is high turnover rates. High turnover rates are a significant issue in healthcare setting. Frequent employee turnover leads to instability within the workforce and increases recruitment and training costs. Second problem statement is job dissatisfaction. Job dissatisfaction is a primary factor contributing to high turnover rates. Dissatisfied employees are more likely to leave their positions, which further exacerbates turnover issue. This dissatisfaction can stem from various factors such as lack of support, inadequate compensation, and high job stress. The next problem statement is negative impact on patient care. High turnover and job dissatisfaction have a direct negative impact on patient care. When healthcare workers leave, continuity of care is disrupted and the quality of care provided to patients may decline. This can lead to poorer patient outcome and lower patient satisfaction. The next problem statement is organizational performance. This issue also affects overall organizational performance. High turnover and low job satisfaction reduce the efficiency and effectiveness of healthcare organizations. Additionally, the constant need to recruit and train new staff increases operational costs, putting further strain on the organizations. Okay, in this slide, focusing and discussing about specific issue at Tengku Azizah Hospital. Okay, the first problem statement is high job demand. At Tengku Azizah Hospital, healthcare workers face extremely high job demands. This demand lead to a significant stress and burnout among employees. As a result, the remaining staff members are burdened with an increased workload, which further exacerbates the problem. The second problem statement is staff turnover. The hospital experiences high staff turnover rates, which negatively affect the continuity of care provided to patients. Frequent turnover means that the new staff must be continuously recruited and trained, leading to increased operational costs and reduced efficiency. To support this problem, various studies have highlighted this issue within Tengku Azizah Hospital. For example, a study by Nazir et al. In 2020 found that the high turnover rates and job dissatisfaction among healthcare workers at the hospital significantly impact patient care and organizational performance. This study provides detailed evidence of the challenges faced by the hospital in maintaining a stable and effective workforce. In summary, addressing the high job demands, reducing staff turnover, and improving job satisfaction are essential steps to enhance the overall performance of Tengku Azizah Hospital and ensure the delivery of high quality patient care. Okay. In this slide, I will outline the main objective of my research, which focuses on the organizational commitment and employee well-being among healthcare workers at Tengku Azizah Hospital in Kuala Lumpur. The first objective of my study is to assess the level of organizational commitment among healthcare workers at Tengku Azizah Hospital. This involves measuring the extent to which employees feel attached to and involved with their organizations. Understanding the current level of OC can provide insight into the overall morale and loyalty of the workforce. Okay. The second objective is to evaluate the well-being of healthcare workers at the hospital. Employee well-being encompasses various aspects such as physical health, psychological states, job satisfaction, and work-life balance. By evaluating these factors, we can gain a comprehensive understanding of the overall health and happiness of the employees. Okay, the third objective is to examine the relationship between organizational commitment and employee well-being. This involves exploring how different levels of OC influence the well-being of healthcare workers. By identifying this relationship, we can determine whether improving organizational commitment can lead to better employee well-being, which in turn can enhance job performance and reduce turnover rates. Okay, let's continue our presentation. Okay, in this slide, I will discuss how enhancing organizational commitment, OC, and employee well-being, EWB, can lead to improved organizational performance. Okay, this is related to link between OC, EWB, and improved performance. High level of organizational commitment among employees lead to a better job performance. When employees are committed to their organization, they are more likely to go above and beyond in their roles, contributing to higher productivity and efficiency. Employee well-being is also crucial. When employees are physically, psychologically, and socially healthy, they are less likely to experience burnout, absenteeism, and turnover. This means they can perform their duty more effectively and consistently. Overall, a workforce that enjoy high level of OC and EWB will be more efficient, leading to a better organizational performance. This is supported by research which is show a strong correlation between high organizational commitment, employee well-being, and enhanced job performance by Nazir et al. In 2020. By focusing on improving both OC and EWB, organizations can ensure a more dedicated and productive workforce, ultimately leading to better performance and success. Okay, let's continue to add the significance of the study, the term of practical implication. One of the significant practical implications of this study is informing policy and practice within the organization. The finding can help develop effective employee retention strategy by understanding what drives organizational commitment and well-being. For example, implementing policy that promote work-life balance, provide professional development opportunities, and ensure a supportive work environment can significantly enhance OC and EWB. Additionally, this study emphasized the importance of employee wellness program. This program can be tailored to address the specific needs of healthcare workers, providing them with the necessary support to maintain their physical and mental health, thereby reducing turnover rates and improving job satisfaction. Okay, in terms of contribution to academic literature, this research also contribute to the academic literature by expanding our understanding of the relationship between organizational commitment and employee well-being. It provides valuable data and insight that can be used by other researchers and practitioners to develop further study and intervention aimed at improving employee satisfaction and performance. By exploring this relationship in the context of Tunku Azizah Hospital, this study adds to the body of knowledge on organizational behavior and human resource management, particularly in healthcare setting. This contribution is crucial for developing theoretical frameworks and practical implications that can enhance employee well-being and organizational performance. In conclusion, the practical implications of this study are significant. They not only help in developing better policy and practice for employee retention and job satisfaction, but also contribute to the academic literature, providing a foundation for further research and practical interventions. Okay, now we're going to move to the second chapter, which is the literature review. Okay, in this slide, I'm going to give an overview of the literature review. The first one is talk about the importance of OC and EWB in healthcare. And the second one is the objective of the literature review. Okay, the importance of OC and EWB in healthcare. Organizational commitment and employee well-being are critical in healthcare setting. High level of OC and EWB are essential for improving job performance, as committed and healthy employees are more productive and efficient. This factor also play a significant role in reducing turnover rates. When healthcare workers are committed to their organization and their well-being is prioritized, they are less likely to leave their job, leading to greater workforce stability. Moreover, enhancing OC and EWB directly impact the quality of patient care. Satisfied and committed healthcare workers provide better care, leading to improved patient outcome and satisfaction. Okay, let's move to the objective of the literature review. The primary objective of this literature review are to examine the factor influencing organizational commitment among healthcare workers. Second objective of this literature review is to explore the determinants of employee well-being in healthcare settings, and then to review the methodologies used in previous study on OC and EWB, and to identify gaps in the existing literature to provide direction for future research. This literature review aims to provide a comprehensive understanding of the relationship between organizational commitment and employee well-being, especially in the context of healthcare workers at Tengku Azizah Hospital. Okay, this slide is mainly talk about factor influencing organizational commitment. Okay, there are a few factors that influencing organizational commitment. The first factor is job satisfaction. Job satisfaction is a key factor influencing organizational commitment. A positive relationship exists between job satisfaction and organizational commitment. Employees who are satisfied with their job due to fair compensation and recognition are more likely to be committed to their organization. The second factor is work environment. A supportive work environment significantly boosts organizational commitment, social relation, collaboration, and the availability of resources within the workplace are crucial. Positive perception of the work environment can control stress level and increase commitment among healthcare workers. The next factor is management support. Management support is critical for fostering employee loyalty. When employees feel supported through training, fairness, and advice, they are more likely to remain committed to their organization. Effective management practice enhance organizational commitment. Okay, the last factor is work-life balance. Balancing work and personal life is essential for reducing stress and increasing organizational commitment. Policies that offer flexibility, such as teleworking and leave option, help employee manage their responsibility effectively. A better work-life balance is linked to higher job satisfaction and commitment. Okay, in this slide, mainly talk about the determinants of employee well-being. Okay, the first one is the mental health. Mental health is a significant determinant of employee well-being. Job stress can severely impact mental health, leading to anxiety, depression, and burnout. Providing organized mental health support improves both employee well-being and performance. Second one is job stress. Job stress originating from high demand, time constraints, and emotional pressure is a major factor affecting employee well-being. Prolonged stress can result in burnout, low job satisfaction, and poor health. Effective supervision and a supportive work climate are essential to mitigate this effect. Okay, next one is a work-life balance. Flexibility in the workplace allowing employees to balance work with a personal life, reduce burnout, and enhance well-being. Policies such as teleworking, vacation, and parental leave are crucial for maintaining a healthy work-life balance. And then the next one is a social support. Social support from colleagues and supervisors plays a crucial role in employee well-being. Encouragement and acceptance within the workplace are associated with higher job satisfaction and lower burnout rates. Positive social interaction enhance both well-being and organizational commitment. Okay, this slide is mainly talk about the methodologies used in previous studies. Okay, the first method that I found is a quantitative approach. Quantitative research methods such as a survey and questionnaire are commonly used in studies on organizational commitment and employee well-being. This method allows for large sample size and statistical analysis, providing robust and generalizable data. The second method that I found in previous study is qualitative approach. The qualitative method, including interview and case studies, offer detailed insight and context-specific data. This approach help in understanding the nuance experience of healthcare workers, although they may not be generalizable as quantitative methods. Okay, the next methodology that I found in a previous study is mixed method approach. Mixed method approaches combine quantitative and qualitative data, providing a comprehensive understanding of OC and EWB. This approach captures both the breadth and depth of information, allowing for a more holistic analysis. Okay. While in I found the gap in the methodologies, despite the strength of this method, there are gaps that need to be addressed. More longitudinal studies are required to understand changes over time. Additionally, there is a need of integrate diverse cultural context into research, as more studies are conducted in Western setting. Okay, in this slide, I will discuss the key findings from previous studies on organizational commitment and employee well-being, particularly in the healthcare sector. Okay, the first one is the correlation between OC and EWB. Research has consistently shown a significant correlation between organizational commitment and employee well-being. Employees with higher level of organizational commitment tend to report better overall well-being. This includes aspects such as job satisfaction, mental health, and physical health. High organizational commitment is associated with positive emotional states and lower level of stress and burnout among employees. Okay, second one is impact of OC on job performance and turnover. Organizational commitment also has a substantial impact on job performance and turnover rates. Studies indicate that employees who are more committed to their organization are likely to perform better in their roles. They are more engaged, motivated, and willing to put in extra effort to achieve organizational goals. Additionally, high level of organizational commitment are linked to lower turnover rates, as committed employees are less likely to leave their organization, reducing the cost and disruption associated with high turnover. In summary, this finding highlight the importance of fostering organizational commitment to enhance employee well-being, improve job performance, and reduce turnover rates in healthcare setting. This slide, I will discuss the gap identified in the literature concerning organizational commitment and employee well-being, particularly in the context of healthcare workers. Okay, the first gaps that I identified is lack of studies in Malaysia context. One of the significant gaps in the existing literature is the lack of studies focusing on the Malaysian context. Most research on OC and EWB has been conducted in Western countries, which have different cultural, economic, and organizational environment compared to Malaysia. This gap highlights the need for more localized research to understand how this factor play out in Malaysia healthcare setting. Okay, the next gap is need for combined study on OC and EWB. Another gap is the need of combined study that simultaneously examine organizational commitment and employee well-being. While there is extensive research on each of these factors individually, there is a lack of study that explore the interaction between OC and EWB. Understanding this relationship is crucial for developing comprehensive strategy to enhance both organizational commitments and employee well-being in healthcare organization. Addressing this gap will provide a more nuanced understanding of how organizational commitment and employee well-being interact in the Malaysian healthcare context and help develop targeted intervention to improve both. Okay, let's move to the last chapter, which is chapter 3, research methodology. Okay, in this slide, I will provide an overview of the methodology that will be used in my study on organizational commitment and employee well-being among healthcare workers at Tengku Azizah Hospital. Okay, the first one is we talk about the quantitative research design. This study employs a quantitative research design. Quantitative research is particularly useful for examining the relationship between variables using a statistical method. By collecting numerical data through structured questionnaire, we can quantify the level of organizational commitment and employee well-being and analyze the correlation between them. This approach allows for objective measurement and analysis, providing robust and generalizable results. While the objective of the methodology, the primary objective of this methodology is to assess and quantify the level of OC and EWB among healthcare workers at Tengku Azizah Hospital. By using a quantitative approach, I aim to measure the extent of organizational commitment and well-being using standardized instruments and analyze the relationship between OC and EWB to understand how they influence each other. And last but not least, to provide data-driven insight that can inform policies and practice to improve employee retention, job satisfaction, and overall organizational performance. In summary, the quantitative research design allows for an objective and systematic examination of the relationship between organizational commitment and employee well-being, which is crucial for developing effective strategy to enhance both in the healthcare setting. This design and approach that will be used in my study on organizational commitment and employee well-being among healthcare workers at Tengku Azizah Hospital. Okay, this study employs a cross-sectional research design. In a cross-sectional study, data is collected from participants at a single point in time. This approach is particularly useful for identifying and analyzing the relationship between variables such as OC and EWB without requiring a long-term commitment to follow up with participants. It provides a snapshot of the current state of this variable within the study population, allowing us to understand their existing level of relationship. Okay. I'm going to use of a standardized questionnaire to gather data. I use a standardized questionnaire. This questionnaire are designed to measure organizational commitment and employee well-being accurately and reliably. The use of standardized instrument ensure consistency in data collection and allow for the comparison of results across a different study. By employing validated scales, we can confidently assess the level of OC and EWB among healthcare workers and analyze the correlation between these variables. In summary, the cross-sectional design and use of a standardized questionnaire enable me to effectively examine the relationship between organizational commitment and employee well-being at Tengku Azizah Hospital, providing valuable insight for improving workforce management and enhancing employee satisfaction. Okay, in this slide, I will discuss the sample size and sampling technique that's gonna be used in my study on OC and EWB among healthcare workers at Tengku Azizah Hospital. Okay, Target population and sample size determination. The target population for this study consists of healthcare workers at Tengku Azizah Hospital in Kuala Lumpur. According to the Hospital Human Resource Department, the total number of healthcare workers is approximately 2,383. To determine the appropriate sample size for this population, I'm going to use the Cretzi and Morgan 1970 table. Based on this table, a population of 2,383 require a sample size of approximately 331 participants. This sample size is large enough to provide reliable and valid data while remaining manageable for data collection and analysis. I'm going to use a random sampling technique to ensure that our sample is representative of the entire population. I'm going to employ a random sampling technique. Random sampling ensure that every individual in the target population has an equal chance of being selected to participate in this study. This technique minimizes selection bias and increases the generalizability of the study finding. By randomly selecting participants from the list of healthcare workers, I can confidently generalize the result to the broader population of healthcare workers at Tengku Azizah Hospital. In summary, using the Cretzi and Morgan 1970 table to determine the sample size and employing a random sampling technique ensure that this study results are both reliable and generalizable, providing valuable insight into the relationship between organizational commitment and employee well-being. Okay, next, I'm going to discuss about the instrumentation that will be used. Okay, in this slide, I will discuss the organizational commitment scale, OCS, that going to be used to measure organizational commitment among healthcare workers at Tengku Azizah Hospital. Okay, the first one, the description of this OCS. The Organizational Commitment Scale, OCS, was developed by Mayer and Allen in 1991. It is a widely used instrument designed to assess the level of commitment an employee has towards their organization. Basically, the scale is based on the three-component model of organizational commitment. Okay. Next is the dimension of the OCS. The OCS include three dimensions. The first one is effective commitment. This dimension measures the emotional attachment an employee has to their organization. Employee with high effective commitment continue employment with the organization because they want to. Second dimension is continuous commitment. This dimension assesses the perceived cost of leaving the organization. Employee with high continuance commitment stay because they feel they need to. The last dimension is normative commitment. This dimension reflects a feeling of obligation to remain with the organizations. Employee with high normative commitment stay because they feel they ought to. Okay, now I'm going to give a sample items in the OCS. Here are some sample items from the OCS. For the effective commitment, I am very happy to spend the rest of my career with these organizations. Next, continuance commitment. Sample item, it is very difficult for me to leave the organization at this time, even if I wanted to. Okay. Sample item for the last dimension for the normative commitment, I will feel guilty if I left my current organization. By using the OCS, I can obtain a comprehensive understanding of the different aspects of organizational commitment among healthcare workers at Tengku Azizah Hospital, Kuala Lumpur. Okay, the second instrumentation that gonna be used in this study is Warwick Edinburgh Mental Wellbeing Scale, WEM, WBS. Okay, the Warwick Edinburgh Mental Wellbeing Scale is a validated instrument designed to measure mental well-being. It focuses on positive aspects of mental health, such as positive feeling and positive functioning, rather than mental illness. The scale includes 14 items, all of which are positively worded, making it suitable for general population surveys and specific groups like healthcare workers. There are the WEM WBS encompasses two main dimensions. The first dimension is positive effect. This dimension measures feeling of optimism, happiness, and relaxation. The second dimension is positive functioning. This dimension assesses energy level, clear thinking, and the ability to deal with problems effectively. Okay, here are some sample items from the WEM WBS. Positive effect. I have been feeling optimistic about the future. Positive effect. I have been feeling useful. Positive functioning. I have been thinking clearly. Positive functioning. I have been dealing with problems well. By using the WEM WBS allow us to gain a detailed understanding of the mental well-being of healthcare workers, providing valuable insight into their overall health and functioning. I will outline the data collection procedure used in my study on organizational commitment, OC, and employee well-being among healthcare workers at Tengku Azizah Hospital. Okay, the detailed process, timing, and ethical consideration. Okay, the data collection process will begin with obtaining approval from the relevant ethics committee and the clinical research center at Tengku Azizah Hospital. Ethical approval ensure that this study adhere to the necessary ethical standard and protects the right of the participants. Participant will be informed about the study objective and procedures, and their informed consent will be obtained before data collection commence. The data is collected using standardized questionnaire, which is distributed to the healthcare workers. The timing of data collection is carefully planned to avoid peak hour and minimize disruption to the participant work schedules. Data collection will take place over a period of 3 months to ensure a high response rates and reliable data. Ethical consideration include obtaining informed consent, ensuring voluntary participants, and providing the right to withdraw from the study at any time without any consequence. Okay, to ensuring the confidentiality and anonymity, each written questionnaire is assigned a unique serial number. No personal identifier will be collected, and all response is kept confidential. Data is stored securely with access limited to the research team. This approach helps build trust among participants and ensure the integrity of data collected. During analysis and reporting, data were aggregated and individual responses were not identifiable, further protecting participant privacy. In summary, the data collection procedure was meticulously planned and executed, prioritizing ethical consideration and ensuring the confidentiality and anonymity of the participants. Okay, in this slide, I will discuss the data analysis techniques that are going to be used in my study on organizational commitment and employee well-being among healthcare workers at Tengku Azizah Hospital. Okay, the first data analysis technique I'm going to be used is descriptive statistic. Descriptive statistic is used to summarize the basic features of the data, providing simple summarize about the sample and the measures. This include measure of central tendency like mean and median, as well as measure of variability like standard deviation. Second one is correlation analysis. correlation analysis will be conducted to determine the strength and direction of the relationship between organizational commitment and employee well-being. This helps in understanding how changes in one variable are associated with changes in another. The third one is regression analysis. Regression analysis will be used to predict the value of the dependent variable, which is employee well-being, based on the value of the independent variable, which is organizational commitment. This technique helps in understanding the impact of organizational commitment on employee well-being. And the last but not least, the analysis of variance, which is ANOVA. ANOVA will be applied to compare the mean of different group and assess the statistical significance of the different observed. This is particularly useful for comparing multiple groups to see if there are significant difference in their level of organizational commitment or well-being. Okay, let's continue for the last slide, which is the use of SPSS for analysis. The statistical software SPSS, which is statistical package for the social sciences, will be used for all data analysis. SPSS is powerful tools that facilitates comprehensive data manipulation and analysis, enabling the application of various statistical techniques mentioned before. Okay, the next three slides are the references for my study that follow the APA 7 format. Okay, the next step involves conducting the data collection process followed by a thorough analysis of the collected data. Based on the finding, recommendation will be made to enhance organizational commitment and employee well-being at Tengku Azizah Hospitals. I look forward to sharing the outcome of this research in future presentation and publications. I think that's all from me. Thank you and Assalamualaikum.